We want to solve the given polynomial inequality, and we're asked to express the solution using inequalities and using interval notation. Let's first review how we solve a polynomial inequality. Step 1, we find all of the zeros of the polynomial. Step 2, we plot these numbers on the number line as open or closed points based upon the original inequality symbol. Step 3, we choose a test value in each interval to see if the interval satisfies the inequality or not. So if the test value produces a true statement, the entire interval is true and part of the solution. If the test value produces a false statement, the entire interval is false and not part of the solution. And then finally, we graph the solution and state the solution using interval notation and or inequalities. So going back to our example, the first step is to find the zeros of the polynomial on the left side of the inequality, which means we want to solve the equation x cubed minus 6x squared minus 4x plus 24 equals 0. So because we have four terms and the only common factor is 1, let's try to solve this by factoring, and we'll use the technique of factor by grouping. So because there are four terms, we divide the polynomial in half, and then we factor the greatest common factor out of the first two terms, then the second two terms. And hopefully we'll have a common binomial factor. Looking at just the first two terms, notice how the greatest common factor is x squared. If we factor out x squared, we'll be left with x minus 6. And now we're hoping to have a factor of x minus 6 when we factor negative 4x plus 24. Well, the greatest common factor of negative 4x and 24 is 4, but if we factor out positive 4, we'd be left with negative x plus 6. Because we want a factor of x minus 6, let's factor out negative 4 instead. So we'll write minus 4. We factor out negative 4, we would be left with x minus 6. Notice how if we distribute negative 4, we do have negative 4x plus 24. Now looking at the two products, notice how we have a common binomial factor of x minus 6. So now we'll factor x minus 6 from these two products. So if we factor out x minus 6, notice how we'd be left with x squared minus 4. X squared minus 4 is a difference of squares, and therefore this factors further. We have a factor of x minus 6, and x squared minus 4 factors into two binomial factors, where one factor is x plus 2, one factor is x minus 2. So this product is equal to 0 when x minus 6 equals 0, or when x plus 2 equals 0, or when x minus 2 equals 0. Solving for x, we have x equals 6, or x equals negative 2, or x equals positive 2. So these are the zeros of the polynomial, and now we need to plot these values on the number line as open or closed points based upon the original inequality symbol. Because we're looking for the x values where the polynomial is less than 0, not less than or equal to 0, we plot these zeros as open points. We plot them as open points because if these are the values that make the polynomial equal to 0, they would not be part of the solution. If the inequality symbol was less than or equal to, then we plot the zeros as closed points. But because the inequality symbol is less than, not less than or equal to, we need to plot the zeros as open points. So we have an open point at negative 2, positive 2, and positive 6. Notice how we just divide the number line into 1, 2, 3, 4 intervals, and now we need to pick a test value in each interval. It does not matter which test value we use, as long as it's in the interval. Let's use a test value of x equals negative 3, x equals 0, x equals 3, and x equals 7. So now we're going to substitute these test values into the original inequality to see if it makes a true or false statement. If it's true, the entire interval is true and the interval is part of the solution. If it's false, the entire interval is false and not part of the solution. So again, now we'll substitute the test values of x equals negative 3, x equals 0, x equals 3, and x equals 7 into the original inequality. And to save some time on the substitution, we'll evaluate the left side using a calculator. To do this, We'll enter the polynomial into y1. So from the home screen, we'll press y equals. And notice I've already entered the polynomial into y1. So now we'll go back to the home screen by pressing second mode for quit. To evaluate the polynomial at x equals negative 3, we now can just enter y1 of 3. So we'll press vars, right arrow, enter, enter, then in parentheses, negative 3. And then enter. And we get negative 45, which means if we substitute negative 3 into the left side of the inequality, the value would be negative 45. So the question is negative 45 less than 0? And the answer is yes, it is. So this is true. So because this is true, all the values in this interval would be true. And the interval to the left of negative 2 is going to be part of the solution. And now we need to test the inequality at x equals 0. Well, if we substitute 0 for x, notice how we just have 0 minus 0 minus 0 plus 24. The inequality would be 24 less than 0. Well, 24 is not less than 0, and therefore this is false, which means all the values in this interval are also false and not part of the solution. And now we test x equals 3, and again we'll evaluate the left side of the inequality using the calculator by entering y1 of 3. So we'll press vars, right arrow, enter, enter, in parentheses 3, enter, and we get negative 15, which means the inequality would be negative 15 less than 0. Negative 15 is less than 0, so because this inequality is true, all the values in this interval between 2 and 6 are also true and part of the solution. And then finally, we test the inequality at x equals 7. To evaluate the left side, we'll enter y1 of 7. So vars, right arrow, enter, enter, 7 in parentheses, and enter, which gives us positive 45. So the question is 45 less than 0? Well, this is false, and therefore all the values in this interval would be false and not part of the solution. So our solution are the intervals that are true, and therefore the graph of the solution would be when x is less than negative 2, or when x is greater than 2 and less than 6. The false intervals are not part of the solution. Now that we have the graph of our solution, let's give the solution using inequalities as well as using interval notation. So using inequalities, we would have x is less than negative 2, or x is greater than 2, and less than 6. And now to express the solution using interval notation, we know as we move to the left, we approach negative infinity, and therefore, using interval notation, x less than negative 2 would be the open interval from negative infinity to negative 2. Notice how we use a random parenthesis to the right of negative 2 because the point is open, meaning negative 2 is not part of the solution. And then we'd have union, the open interval from 2 to 6. Again, we use parentheses because the endpoints are not included. If they were included, we would use brackets. And finally, before we go, let's verify our solution by analyzing the graph of y equals x cubed minus 6x squared minus 4x plus 24. So here's the graph of the polynomial, and because we're trying to determine where the polynomial is less than 0, graphically that would be when the graph is below the x-axis. Notice how the graph is below the x-axis here, as well as here. Looking at the x values where this occurs when x is less than negative 2, or when x is greater than 2 and less than 6. So this graph does verify our solution is correct. Remember, a function is negative when it's below the x-axis, and positive when it's above the x-axis, and 0 at the x-intercepts, or where it crosses the horizontal axis. I hope you found this helpful.